This morning on The Dish, the chef who brought his own version of California cuisine back to his native Midwest. Erling Wu-Bower grew up in Chicago, where his mom Olivia was a talented cook who went on to become executive chef at Google. In California, she was inspired by the state's incredible produce, and Wu-Bower was too.
After jobs at top Chicago restaurants, he opened Pacific Standard Time, featuring fresh California produce and local meats, all cooked on wood-fired grills. The restaurant won this year's James Beard Award for Best Design, and now a rooftop venue, the Laurel Room, is set to open later this month. And Chef Erling Wu-Bower, good morning and welcome to The Dish.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Oh, absolutely. Now, you already told us you're going to start with our favorite, but tell us what's on the table here.
So this is a very easy cocktail to execute. It's a simple hibiscus margarita. So cheers.
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 Thank you so much for having me.
Welcome.
And then we have a cucumber and tomato salad with basil vadouvan vinaigrette. Mm. We love burrata cheese. This is a steak with a plum, cucumber, and zug, which is a Yemenite kind of pumpkin seed pesto, for lack of a better term. Mm-hmm. This is a Pacific Standard Time classic right here. Field greens with a miso tahini vinaigrette. Vegan, delicious, incredibly healthy. Some grilled broccoli with creme fraiche, peanuts, and corn. And maybe most excitingly, some tres leches cake.
Which looks amazing.
Right.
Absolutely amazing. You know, we mentioned that your mom is a chef. You grew up, your dad is Cajun.
He is.
So what was that like as far as the influences on you in your childhood?
I mean, it was the kind of household where we would talk about what was for dinner at breakfast. Right,
that's how life
revolved around food. And, you know, it was kind of the fabric of life was just how we related to each other. It's how we relate to each other today, so.
That's what we do here.
Does mom get mad saying you should be cooking what I cook and dad says you should be cooking what I'm used to?
Mom certainly gets mad, yeah, for sure. She'll review this and tell me what's up.
Nice,
very nice.
As she should.
I guess you had a lot of influences too. I loved reading Rick Bayless, an influence on you from early on.
Yeah, I got really lucky in my culinary influences. Rick was a good friend of my mom's and became a good friend of mine. And was really influential. The major lesson I took from him was people don't go out to eat what they eat at home. It's like, put some vinegar on it, add some salt to it, make sure it's full of flavor. Cook with fruit, grill things, the fire's delicious. So it's a big influence.
I'm interested in how you see your interpretation of California cuisine being from the Midwest. How did you put that twist on it?
So, to rewind a little bit, my mom was a food writer, and she's Chinese. She's a first-generation immigrant. And we, of course, cook Chinese food at home, but we also, you know, went shopping at Mexican markets, farmers markets, your average grocery store, Thai groceries. So we were cooking this really intimate American cuisine at home, and calling it fusion would be a crime. It was just, it's American food.
Yeah.
And she moved out to California, and the food that we were cooking already in a suburb of Chicago became more of itself because of the access to ingredients out there, because there's a massive Chinese population out there, because there's a massive Hispanic population out there. So the essence of the food just kind of increased when she was out there. But then you go out there and you eat in those restaurants and there's a real food conversation going on in California. Right?
What do you mean about that?
I wish I could take credit for this line. Stuart Brioza, one of my favorite chefs, said the California diner expects cross-cultural kind of conversations in their food, right? They expect to go out and eat, you know, interesting things in their pastas and write interesting things over their steak. I really feel like it's this mishmash of different cultures which really represents America in general.
Right.
So is the wood fire part of your Cajun background?
No, it's just part of the key to good food, right? Everybody comes in all the time and they're like, well, what makes the food so good? I'm like, it's the fire. And people are like, well, why? What's the secret? It's the fact that we cook it over wood.
It's wood and it's flames.
Right,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
It's really not.
Yeah,
and your college degree was in what?
Philosophy.
Philosophy.
Mm-hmm.
Was that a real, I'm going to become a philosopher, or use this somehow, or
no.
Was it always about food?
Not one bit real.
Yeah.
you know, it was always going to be food. With my parents being who they are, you know, there was never, besides wanting to be a firefighter when I was four, right?
Like,
your DNA, right?
There was nothing else that it was going to be. It was, you know, it was something that my family does, and I'm super happy that I did it, but it certainly helps me you know, deal with people, which is another part of my job.
You have lived it for and continue to live it. I'm going to have you sign the dish. If you could have this meal with anyone, past or present, who would it be? Besides us, of course.
Mm-hmm.
My staff. I'd love to share this meal with my staff, right? I think that kitchen staffs and dishwashing staffs and service staffs never get enough credit.
They don't.
So I definitely want to share it with my staff. And then a quick Bruce Springsteen mention, right?
Hello.
We got to have entertainment,
if I could share
too,
it with
right?
the boss.
The employees and Bruce.
And Bruce.
Yeah, there you go.
Good combination.
Erling Wu-Bower, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me. It was amazing.
And if you want to learn more about Erling and the dish, you can head to our website at cbsthismorning.com.